Welcome to the conic section of an ellipse. An ellipse is the set of all points in a plane. The sum of distances from two fixed points of the plane is constant. The two fixed points are called the foci, which is the plural of focus of the ellipse. This is the first focus and the second focus. The line rudder is sometimes called the focal axis. The points on the focal axis midway between the foci is the center, so this is the center. And the points where the ellipse crosses its focal axis are called the vertices. So this is the vertex 1 and the vertex 2. The line segment through the two vertices is called the major axis. So this line is called the major axis. And the line segments through the center and perpendicular to the major axis is called the and terminating the ellipse is called the minor axis. So this is the minor axis. When we graph this slide as well. So the eccentricity of the curve tells us the amount of roundness of that curve. Now, the eccentricity of the through the circle is t, and that is of the parabola is 1, while the eccentricity of the ellipse is between 0 and 1. So between this 1 and 0 and 1. And that is, the eccentricity is greater than 0, but less than 1. A small eccentricity indicates that the ellipse is tends up towards circular, whereas the eccentricity close to 1 indicates that the ellipse is elongated. So like this one is an elongated ellipse.
Our first problem is find the equation of the ellipse with the center at the origin foci at positive negative 3, 0 and the vertices of positive negative 0. Then find the length of the lattice rectum, eccentricity, and sketch the graph. So, our center is already given, which is 0 and 0. And the foci, focus 1 is positive 3, 0. And focus 2, negative 3, 0. Then our vertex 1 is positive 4, 0, vertex 2, negative 4, 0. Then, to get our C, which is the value of the eccentricity, C is equal to 3, then the square root C squared is equal to, you may square root 3, the equivalent of 9. So RE is our vertex. Is A is equal to 4, and we square 4 is equal to 16. So RB is unknown. So to solve RB, which is the minor axis, is b squared is equal to c squared minus a squared. So c squared, r c squared here is 9 minus the r a squared, which is 16. So to solve for b squared is equal to a squared minus c squared. So a squared is 16, will be subtracted by the value of c squared, which is 9. So b squared is equal to 7, and RB is equal to square root of 7, and the approximate value of 2.65. Then our major axis is, that is 2a is equal to 2a is equal to c times R vertex, which is A, is equal to 2 A, which is 4, is equal to the value of C, which is 3, to be multiplied by the value of vertex, is equal to 8. So 8 is equal to 3 times 4 is equal to 12. So we divide it by 2, and by 4 rather. So is 2b is equal to 3 times the square root of the value of b, R2B is 3, 7. So our entrance of minor axis. Axis are 0, 0, square of 3 square of 7, and our B2 is 0, negative 3 square of 7. The next is to find our lattice vector. B squared over A is equal to R2B divided by RB. So the value of B squared is 7. So 7. Then the value of A, which is 4. Then we multiply 2 times 7 is equal to 14 over 4 is equal to 14 divided by 4 is 7. Then we branch it by 2, so 7 over 4. 7 over 4 with the approximate, so 7 by 2, then with the approximate value of 5.3. So we divide it by 2, so it becomes 7 over 2, then with the branches of 1 and 3, 4, 1 and 3, 4, and then the approximate value of 1.75. Then the endpoints of our lattice vector are 3 and 1 and 3, 4, negative 3, comma 1 and 3, 4, negative 3, comma negative 1 and 3, 4, and positive 3, comma negative 1 and 3, 4. The next is to get our eccentricity. So eccentricity is equal to C over A. So the value of our C is 3 over the value of A, which is 4. Then we divide it is equal to 0.75. So now we can write our graph. So First, locate the center. Our center is 0. Then next is foci, which is focus 1 is positive 3, 0. And our focus 2 is negative 3, comma 0. The next is our vertices, which is vertex 1 is positive 4, comma 0. And then our vertex 2 is negative 4, comma 0. The next we locate our minor axis. So our minor axis is square root of 0, square root of 7. So square root of 7 is 265. So see, this is our V1. Next is to have our focus. Next is our lattice rectum. So first is 3, and 1, 3, 4, 3. 3, 1, 3, 4, and the positive value is 3, 7, 5, 7. 3, 1, negative 3, comma 1, 3, 4, and negative 3, comma, negative 1, 3, 4, then last is positive 3. Now we can put our points. So so this is the graph to our equation on problem number 1. So now let's go to the problem number 2. The problem number 2 is discuss the graph of the equation 3x squared plus 5y squared minus 24x minus 15y minus 3 is equal to 0. So in this equation, the constant value to make it positive we transpose it to the right side. So 3x squared plus 5y squared minus 24x minus 15y is equal to negative 30. That transpose to the right, it becomes positive 33. The next is we get the square root of both of them. So x squared plus 24x is minus 24x. Oh, so we get if 24 divided by 3, it becomes 8, and x then plus 5 and quantity of y squared minus 15 divided by 5, it becomes 3y is equal to positive 43. Then next is, if a multiplied is by 1 half, I add 1, it all the quantities. So 3x squared minus 8x plus 1 plus 5y squared minus 3y plus 1 is equal to 73. So from this ratio, all of the must multiply this inside the quantity to the outer. Then transpose all the constants to the right side, so it becomes x squared minus 8x. X squared minus 8x so comes 2 discuss the graph of the equation, which is 3x squared plus 5y squared minus 24x minus 15y is equal to minus 33 is equal to 0. So we're going to transpose the constant number to the right side so that it becomes positive. So 3x squared plus 5y squared minus 24x minus 15y. So negative 33 transpose to the right becomes positive 33. Then next is to factorize. So 3x squared plus the factor of 24 is 8 and 3 is 8x plus 5y squared. Factor of 15 is 3 minus 3 pi c pi 2 33. And x is 2. Add 1 h of this. So 3 x squared plus 8x plus 1 plus 5 y squared minus 3 y plus 1 is equal to 33. Then this is the transpose of a constant to the right. So it becomes 3. Suppose thus x squared plus 8x plus 1 plus 5y squared minus 3y plus 1 is equal to 33. Minus 3 minus 5 is equal to 33 minus 3 is 33 minus first is the like sign, so 33 plus 3 minus 5, negative 5 is negative 8 minus negative 8 minus 33, so 33 minus negative 8, so becomes 25, so 25, so come. Next is x of x plus 9 minus 1. Plus 1 squared over the 33 plus 7. So 33 divided 25 by 5 is 5 plus 25 is 5 of 3 is 3 is equal to 1 x is 1, so 1. Then next is we're going to find RA, so RA squared is equal to, this is RA squared, 3 of the square root of A is square root of 3, so the approximate value of, so A squared is equal to square root of 3, that's approximate value is 1.73. The next we're going to locate our B squared. So our B squared is equal to B squared is B squared is 5. So 5. So our B is equal to B squared. So, R, this is equal to the square root of 5, Then the approximate value of 2.2 atoms. The approximate value of 2.24. Then next is we're going to locate our H is equal to 1. Then our K is equal to 9. Then our C, which is the center of C, 1.1. Then next is to get our value of us, C is equal to the square of A squared minus the
balik. Sige, susunod na.
So RC is equal to value of A, which is 3 minus the value of B, which is 5. Then the result is C is equal to the square root of negative 2. Then we can approximate value of 2. See, the approximate value of 2 is the approximate value of 1.21. So now it's RB squared over A. B squared over A is equal to B squared is 5 over A is 3. C is equal to positive negative square root of A squared minus B squared is equal to square root of 3 minus 5. R C squared is C is equal to square root of 2. So we have the value of 1.41. So our lattice rectum next is to get our lattice rectum formula is 2b squared over a. So 2 times 5, which is the value of b squared over the value of a squared, is the square root of 3, is equal to 10 over square root of 3. So the branches are 5 over square root of 3, and the approximate value of it. So our inference of the lattice rectum is square root of 2 comma 5 over square root of 3, then square root of negative 2. So our inference of the lattice rectum is square root of 2 comma 5 over square root of 3, then square root of negative 2 comma 5 over square root of 3, then negative square root of 2 comma negative square root of 5 over square root of 3, then and square root of 2 comma negative square root of 5 over 3. So now let's plot our points in the Cartesian plane. Then first we're gonna do is to find our center is 0, 0. Then the foci are focus 1, which is square root of 2, equivalent of 1.41, so this our focus one. And focus 2 square root of negative 2 under 0 is our focus 3. Then our vertices are And then next is R, the value R minor axis. So R minor axis is square root of 5, the value of 2.4. So next is our lattice inverse of our lattice. So square root of 2, which is square root equivalent of 1.41, then 5 over 3 equivalent of 2.89. So this is the graph of our equation, problem number 2, the graph is circular. That's all, thank you.